Hello friends, welcome to Simply Learn. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install and configure ELK in just 3 steps. This is the prerequisites. The user should have basic knowledge in Linux or Windows operating system, and it is good to have a basic understanding of Ansible, but this is absolutely optional. Before starting, we will discuss a bit about ELK. What is ELK? ELK is a stack. It's a collection of 3 open source products, which is ElasticSearch, Logstash, and Kibana, all developed and managed and maintained by Elastic. ElasticSearch is a NoSQL database that is based on Lucene search engine. Logstash collects and parses logs. ElasticSearch indexes and stores the information, and Kibana visualizes the data. It's basically a stack of ElasticSearch, Logstash, and Kibana, which is used for log processing. And if you go to the next slide, which is a more visualization of the whole stack, which is the log, which is actually the data source, log source here, and log source is this bit actually, and bit collects the logs and send to Logstash. Logstash is a data processor which process the data and send to Elasticsearch storage. Here we store all the logs from a number of devices, and here is a Kibana where we visualize the data. Actually, here we do different kinds of dashboards and many things. What we do with the logs, but here we have the data in Elasticsearch, and what we do with that will be in Kibana, where we can create very nice dashboards where we can see the whole infrastructure in a single page. In this video I'm going to explain all the installation and configuration of the Elasticsearch Logstash and Kibana stack, but there will be another video I'll be uploading in the coming days, which is purely for visualizing the data and creating dashboards and how to create nice dashboards where we can see many information in many graphs, many pie charts or whatever data that will be coming uploaded in the coming days. I'm preparing that video, so please subscribe my channel to get notified when the video is ready and it is uploaded. Moving to that's about ELK, which is that I don't want to go much deep into the theory part. I'm just moving to the practical section where how we deploy and configure Elasticsearch ELK stack. So basically the installation is consists of a few things, which is this will guide you how to install and configure ELK stack, and this is an automated installation which is using an Ansible playbook. And this Ansible playbook will do all these steps. First one is configuring ELK stack. Second, install a front-end web server. And the third one is configure customized directories to manage and index data. Sometimes we might end up with filling a file system. So it is better to load all your data into a different file system where we or a storage which has more storage capacity. And configure firewall. By default the Kibana port which is 5601, which is open to everyone. And what I tried to do with this playbook, with this installation procedure, is configure firewall and block 5601 port, and no one can access directly to Kibana. And the access will be based through the web server. It's a basic HTTP server, and it is I'm using a very basic authentication using HTTP password, but you can do whatever the authentication mechanism you can use. So I'm using this HTTP password based security configuration for Kibana, and using a default static password, username and password, we can access the Kibana dashboard. I'll show you how to how it's doing. And install, there is one more thing I have included in this playbook, which is curator installation of curator installation configuration of curator, which is curator is a tool which will clean up your logs in the Elasticsearch directories based on the time frame. If you want, if you don't want, if you need only last 3 months data, you can remove archive the data, which will be helpful to avoid filling up the file system. If you end up the if you fill up the file system, then Elasticsearch will be crashed, and it is not very good. So I'm included the curator also here, which is I will tell you how to do that. In this video we will only go through the installation and basic configuration part. And more about curator will be coming in the upcoming videos. So it's better to subscribe now. Okay. So let's open the procedure then. That's all. It's very simple. Install and configure ELK on. I'm using CentOS VM to show you a demo of this, which is I installed on VirtualBox. These are the three steps I'm going to do for this complete installation. All my codes are in my Git repository here. This is install ELK. You can use this if you want to try. Okay, this is a public repository. And what I'm doing is I'm cloning my Git repository, and just updating a few things in the inventory file of Ansible, and running the playbook. That's all. Okay, let's start then. Here I have my VM here. Okay, it's 7, CentOS 7. Straight away I'm starting the procedure. Before that, I would like to give you an introduction about or some knowledge about the playbook, what the playbook actually does. Okay, this is my Git repository. Here I have this install ELK, and this is my actual playbook. Here I have let's go to the, I don't want to give more into Ansible, and I don't want to give that much things. I'm going to upload many videos for Ansible in separate. Okay, let's go to the task. I just give you an overview of what we do with this playbook. Here is my ML. So the first step, which is install JDK RPM Java, it's based on Java, so we need a JDK. And here it's downloading the Elasticsearch RPM from its official repository, which is from Elastic. And here installing Elasticsearch RPM download, this is his next tool, next stack, which is Kibana, and install Kibana. And the third one, which is Logstash, download Logstash, and here install Logstash. Okay, then this is a curator, which is the curator is available in this repository itself, so you just need to copy the curator RPM and install it. Okay, installing curator, these are RPM installation. Then here we configure the install the web server, it's a basic installation of HTTPD package. And here we start web server and creating some directories to manage the Elasticsearch data. You can create new file systems on this directory if you want, if you don't want to fill up your root file system. Okay, here is creating directory. Here there are some templates, which is Elasticsearch templates, which is actually the configuration of Elasticsearch. There are a few things that we need to edit. So here I have already the template available in the source, and it is just copying the template to the destination directory, the Elasticsearch server. Here, copy Kibana template, and this Logstash, copying Logstash, step one, step two. I'm not going to deep step one. And here copying some more templates for Logstash beats configuration, and here say it's notifying whenever there is a configuration change, it is notifying to restart Logstash. That is much needed. Here starting the services Kibana, and here configure web server. Here I'm configuring the HT password based authentication. The default username and password is Kibana. And here installing firewall and configuring firewall. Okay, that's fine, the standard steps. And here configuring curator, it's and creating some directory for this directory is needed for curator to operate, where we have some configurations about how the curator should work. Here there are some templates for the curator, which is delete Logstash index, which is more than 30 days, like that. And there is one more thing which is this will do is metric beat, which is collecting the metric data of the servers. This is for curator. Here we need to install metric beat RPM. It's a different product, which is available from Elasticsearch. We need to install it to use it. So I'm not installing metric beat in this. I'm going to do this. Okay, here curator. That's all. Here it's you get. So that's about the tasks we are going to do with this playbook. I'm going to run this now. Let's go to our procedure. I'm going to create a directory, ELK or something. Okay, here I clone my Git repository. Okay, we have downloaded the clone to the Git repository here, and I'm just checking. Okay, there is a folder install. Here we have the repository here. Okay, let's check the inventory file. I use the name inv for inventory file. Here I will explain a few things, which is first one, which is the ELK server, where this means where we are going to deploy this this ELK stack. Okay, I'm going to deploy this on the same server where I'm working on, which is a DevOps. The host name is DevOps one. Okay, so I put and one more thing you should know, which is the SSH passwordless authentication should be enabled. Key-based authentication should be enabled. Between the host where you are running the playbook and where you want to deploy the ELK server. So this is a local host where I have already done the already updated the SSH keys. So this is the server where I'm going to deploy ELK. And here this is the variables. Normally, in normal cases, you don't need to edit this anything unless you need to change this syslog port of Logstash. Here I use 1051514 as the syslog port where it listens for the logs. Okay, so it's a Logstash actually. It's a Logstash port, and where in through this port we receive logs from different sources. So you can send logs from anywhere. Like I used this I have installed this ELK in one of for one of our customer, where I sent logs from almost all the Linux servers, including which is more than 1,000 Linux servers, its hardware, GPFS, it's a cluster software, a file system software, and the many other application softwares. All are sending data to ELK, and we have a nice dashboard server we created to monitor and monitor the health check of the devices based on the logs. So I use normally I use 10514. So if you want, you can change this port. This is the default ElasticSearch URL where it is running on 9200 port. And these directories you can it's configurable. And here if you want, you can create new file systems. Basically, ELK data occupies more, so you can create a big file system for ELK where we store ELK data. So where we store all the logs from n number of sources. Here we store. So it's configurable, but normally in normal cases, if you want basic installation or try, you don't need to do this. Okay. And this is the one. These packages were. These are the packages I'm going to install here, but there is a latest package is available, which is 6.6. I'm using 6.3. If you want to have latest package, you just need to change the version here. That it will automatically, this playbook will check the package you want, and it will install accordingly. If it's it should be available in the repository. Okay. And this is a Kibana package, this is a Logstash package, and this is a curator package. And this is a curator, which is a. And this one thing you should remember is these three packages should be compatible. Which is it should be in the same version, which is 6.3.2. Else it won't work. Okay, that's about the inventory file. What all you need to edit is the ELK server, where you need to update the host name or IP address of the server or of the host where you want to deploy ELK. Okay. Okay, I think we are done editing the inventory file. I'm just checking the SSH key is enabled for this host. Yes, it should work. Okay, let's run the playbook then. First, it is installing JDK RPM. JDK installation is completed. Now it's installing ElasticSearch. I have already downloaded ElasticSearch RPM. And saved in the temp folder of the server where we want to deploy ELK. So the download time is saved here. It's around 150 MB RPM. It might take a bit if internet connectivity is not so good. Currently it's installing Kibana. Kibana is completed, now it's installing Logstash. Okay, Logstash is completed, now it is installing Curator. It's an optional, if you really want you can, but anyway it will install, this playbook will install Curator also. If you want you can use. I'm using this for this to clean up the logs what that is no longer needed. Okay. it's installing httpd package. It's creating the necessary required directories and copying the Jinja templates. Starting the services and it's doing additional configuration of web server, which is basically the HTTP password authentication and the redirection of the URL proxy the URL to of Kibana. Now it's installing firewall to package to enable to block it's basically to block the ports ports of Kibana, and it will open only the ports what is needed to run ELK. So if you want to add additional ports for some other service, you need to do it manually. Configuring and starting firewall, configuring curator. This is going to be the final steps, and finally it's restarting all the services. Here you see the message ELK stack installation completed successfully. Your Kibana URL is this one. That's all. Now our installation is successfully completed, and we can now check our Kibana dashboard and other services. Okay, this is our URL, and this will not be resolvable from my browser, so I'm using the actual IP of the server. This is the IP here. Going to paste the URL here. Yes, it's asking for username and password. This is the HT password authentication. The default username and password, which is Kibana, the username is Kibana, and the password is also Kibana. It's loading the Kibana dashboard, Kibana URL. Okay, there are many things here. Here we have discover where we could see the logs. Here we can visualize the data. Here it's this dashboard, this timely on. There are many things here. I'm not going to into deep in this video. I'm making a different video for just to configure logs, to how to send logs to our ELK server, and how we can create indexes, how we can discover the logs here, and how we can visualize the logs, and finally dashboards. So these things, I'm combining all these things in, and also curator. So how do you use a curator to clean up the logs directory? I will make another video for that, and I will upload in my YouTube channel. So please don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. So guys, thanks for watching, and if you like this video, please don't forget to like this video, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks again. Have a great day. Bye-bye.